Now I think you have a good idea of what PCA generally does, and I want to take a step back and talk about it as a general algorithm for feature transformation. So remember what we started with was four features that we manually split up into two categories. We said square footage and number of rooms are related to size, and the safety in schools are related to the neighborhood. Then we applied PCA to each of those independently, and we came up with that single feature. Then we can put those features into, say, a regression and come up with a house price. You could also imagine that these would be good inputs for a classifier if you're trying to answer some slightly different question. But there's a little bit of a problem here, and maybe it's been bothering you. And that's this step right here, that we manually took our input features and we used our human intuition to figure out how we should group them. And the problem with this is that this manual process is not scalable. Let's suppose we're trying to use PCA for something like facial recognition, where the inputs might be thousands or tens of thousands or even millions of pixels in a picture. There's no way that we could inspect all of those pixels by hand and try to split them up according to what we think might be the combinations that make the most sense and then apply PCA to each of those individually. But here's the magic of PCA. I can take a second strategy with this. What I can do is I can put all four of these features into PCA together, and it can automatically combine them into new features and rank the relative powers of those new features. So if we have the case where we have two latent features that are driving most of the variation in the data, PCA will pick those out and it will call them the first and the second principal components. Where the first principal component, the one that has the most effect, might be something like neighborhood, and the second principal component might have something like size. It's a little bit harder to make these interpretations now, because what can and does happen is that the first principal component will be an admixture that has little bits and pieces from potentially all of the features. But this is a very powerful unsupervised learning technique that you can use to fundamentally understand the latent features in your data. If you knew nothing about housing prices at all, PCA would still be able to give you an insight like, there are two things that seem to drive the house prices in general. It would still be up to you to figure out that they're the neighborhood and the size. But in addition to doing dimensionality reduction now, you're also learning something fundamentally important about the patterns of the variation in your data.